story. I didn't know it until I met the Mr. Ansbacher tonight. He said, don't you remember me? And I said, no. He said, I was a White House scholar when you were in the White House. Well, there were about 30 of them, and I didn't see them every day. So he told me of his experience working in the White House and as an assistant to Bill Coleman, who was Secretary of Transportation. So I can verify that he was in the White House and that he did a good job. I'm sure you're very proud of him here as a leader of the Colorado Springs Symphony. Sorry Betty's not here, but she's doing about half the things, and she asked me to give her very best to each and every one of you. I'm sure we're going to have a delightful evening. I want to thank the Vail Valley Foundation that did all the fundraising and all the planning and the activities for this beautiful amphitheater. Bob Nouse, Harry Frampton, and all the others who have done such an outstanding job over the last several years. We were in the process of raising money and constructing this fine facility. So on behalf of Betty and myself, I welcome you and hope and trust you'll have a most delightful evening. Thank you.
It is a great pleasure for the Colorado Springs Symphony Orchestra to be again in Vail at this wonderful Gerald Ford Amphitheater. And I would like to thank President Ford for that most gracious introduction. We are going to play for you a concert which has begun with music by Sousa, but will include mostly works from the classical repertoire. We have with us this afternoon Michaela Paetsch, a violinist who was born and brought up in Colorado Springs and has now been recognized around the world as one of the great young virtuosos. And she will play for us the Mendelssohn Violin Concerto. Would you welcome, please, Ms. Michaela Paetsch. Thank you.
Thank you.